So you've sharpened your skills at using ClickUp, and now you're wondering,
can I turn this into a business?
If you have the business skills and the ClickUp skills, the answer is most likely yes. And in this video, I'm going to break down 6 different ways that you can monetize your ClickUp skills if that's something that you're looking to do. Now, before we dive deep into each of these methods, I'm just going to go through what the 6 ones are. First of all, we have executing. So this is going to be where you are focusing on the hands to keyboard time of executing some kind of change in a ClickUp account. Setups, where you're going to be taking a broader look at actually designing a ClickUp account. Strategy audits, where you're going to be taking something that exists, finding ways to improve it, and executing on that. Number 4 is a ClickUp using service. Now, this is not an elegant name, so maybe you guys can help me come up with a better one, but this is referring to people who are doing an activity, something, but as part of that role, they're also using ClickUp at an expert level. So maybe you're a virtual assistant, but you know how to use ClickUp very well. You're an OBM, but you know how to use ClickUp very well. The actual job you're doing is not for ClickUp, but you're in ClickUp while doing it, and so your knowledge of ClickUp is a value add. The 5th method to monetize your ClickUp skill is actually selling assets. So this could be templates, IP, courses, anything in this arena. The 6th method is a bit more nebulous, and it's what I'm doing right here. And that's creating a YouTube channel or creating a content base that you are then able to monetize that traffic, monetize that attention. And basically what you're selling in that is entertainment or education, and you're getting paid not by the people consuming it, but by others in that flow. So first things first, we have execution setups. These are people who will basically take your order and say, what do you want? Oh, you want a document? I'll make a document. How do you want the document to look? Oh, okay, I will make that document. You want me to import data? Sure, I'll import data. Execution setups are people who are order takers, kind of like, let's just say, a personal chef for your ClickUp account. You'll find execution setup providers in the ClickUp Consultants database, on Fiverr, on Upwork, and via subcontractors all across the internet. There's pretty high supply when it comes to this kind of skill set. These kind of service providers are pretty low risk for a buyer because the buyer is pretty much telling you exactly what they want and you are setting it up. Because the buyer has to design exactly what they want and just tell you what their order is, they have a medium level of responsibility in this process. They have to get pretty well prepped and tell you, again, exactly what they want, which is more time intensive than some of the other options we have for buyers. Clients of execution setup providers tend to be relatively high skill and or they just have a high volume of repetitive work. So the work itself isn't particularly complex, and the buyers usually know what they want if they are a good fit for done-for-you services. When it comes to the service provider's experience providing execution services, this is pretty low stress, like I'll say low to medium. This is gonna be a pretty relaxing flow for you as a service provider to just follow their instructions and give them what they want. You are just fulfilling the order. When it comes to execution services, you're gonna see a range of prices from $20 to $75 US per hour. I would say that's pretty standard, and most providers are on the lower end of that, in the $20 to $50 range. Particularly on Upwork. The reason for that is this is a relatively low stress environment. You're not bringing a lot of strategy to the table. You don't have a lot of ways to add value. And just to be blunt, there's a lot of competition in this space. A lot of people have the requisite skills to offer these kinds of services. So you're competing with a lot more people, especially people who don't have teams or other overhead. So they're able to charge much less than what you might want to charge for these kinds of services. Because this is a lower pay bracket, when you are looking at this kind of business model, you're going to be at the high to medium volume of clients. So you might have projects that only last a few hours if you're in the execution game, up to maybe a few weeks, but you're not going to have long drawn out engagements like we're going to see in other models. But if you're someone that likes to work with smart people who know what they want, if you like to just, you know, put your headphones on, get some stuff done, and data entry kind of is soothing to you, if you're just getting started in the space and you want to get some reps in, this can be a great place to start. Ooh, and if you are a ClickUp service provider watching this video and you might have some questions come up about what I'm talking about, go down to the description of this video and you will find a link to a form. Basically, I'm looking to do some more content for you guys to solve issues that you are faced with when it comes to providing and monetizing your ClickUp skills. And I would really love to hear directly from you as to what you would like to see to solve that. So you'll see the form in the description below. Just click the link. You can fill it out anonymously in just a few minutes, and I would really, really appreciate hearing from you. So anyway, back to the video. The next type of service we want to talk about is setup services. So while execution and setup can have some overlap, what I'm talking about here is someone who combines a little bit of strategy with some execution. So rather than a buyer coming to this person and saying, here's what I want, when it comes to a setup provider in this space, they're asking a few more questions they're challenging what that buyer comes to them with, and they're educating that buyer along the way. So this person's bringing a bit more strategy to the table, and accordingly, you're going to see some of these values reflect that. So when it comes to risk for the buyer, this is another low risk setup, even though the price point, which we'll talk about soon, is higher for these services. This is a much higher touch experience, which increases the chances of success. And because the service provider is bringing a little strategy to the table, it actually makes it easier to ensure that the buyer is building something that actually makes sense. Because this is still in that done for you territory, it might be even called done with you, this is still pretty low responsibility for the buyer. They don't have to do too much in this setup. At least they don't have to do as much as they did for the execution provider, but you are gonna pick up that slack. So for the service provider providing these kinds of services, brace yourself. This is gonna be a medium to high stress engagement for you. Every single client is gonna be pretty demanding. There's always gonna be something you don't anticipate. Scope of work and contracts for these kinds of services are particularly challenging. And the things that are unforeseen or that develop as you're building out a ClickUp account can really introduce more risk for you of going over budget or going over time. Depending on how tech savvy your users are and how much training you have built into that flow, you also have the risk of people not actually adopting the thing that you're building. So actually increasing your buyer responsibility here, making them do more in the process, could lower your stress levels. But with that comes a bit of a trade-off for who your buyer is going to be. What kind of ideal client are you going to have? When it comes to hourly rates in US, I would say the low end that we're seeing for these kinds of setup plus strategy hybrid people are around $60 per hour US, all the way up to $200, $300 per hour US. I will also say at this point, we're gonna see more and more productized services be introduced. So things like packages, some of the lowest prices you're gonna see that are, you know, even worth considering is gonna be around $1,500 for these setup services of a simple workspace. If you're the person offering that rate though, please increase that. That is very, very low. I would say the average price right now in USD of a workspace setup in ClickUp is gonna be from $2,500 to $5,000. That's probably the average, but as you get into agency models, I mean, there are service providers who are charging 30 plus thousand for a ClickUp structure setup, even for smaller teams of say 10 to 20 people. So huge range here, but from 1500 to 30,000, that's kind of your range in here. And most people I would say are between the 2.5K and the 5,000 in this bracket. So check yourself there. And what's gonna determine where you fall is how organized your processes are, who your ideal client is, and how big of a problem you're solving, and you know, how much risk you can reduce for your buyer. These setup services could be intensives of a day or two or a week, but most commonly you're gonna see them stretch out over 2 to 8 weeks. Setups tend to be a longer and more intense engagement, which correlates with that price point. Now, that brings us to the next offer, the next option for monetizing your ClickUp skills, which is strategy audits. Strategy audits tend to be delivered in an intensive format, whether that's an hour, a day, a weekend. And in some cases, we will see strategy audits follow a coaching model of, you know, a half hour a month or something like that, more of a coach format of continuous improvement. But those are the two most common formats for this strategy audit setup. When it comes to a strategy audit, there's a medium risk level for the buyer. They don't necessarily know that you can solve their problem unless they've really gotten to know you through a community, your content, something else. There's always that risk that they're gonna bring a question that you aren't actually able to solve in the time that you have, particularly because most strategy engagements have that intensive format, so you don't really have time to Google things if you don't know it. You really need to know your stuff to reduce the risk to your buyer. When it comes to responsibility, we're at the medium to high responsibility part for the buyer because of the fact that strategy is usually just guidance, just recommendations. Both the question to ask and the implementation of the advice is gonna fall on the buyer or the customer. So that's pretty risky for them. They need to know that they have the right question, or at least, you know, close to the right question, and they have to know that they can handle implementing whatever their consultant is suggesting. As you might have gathered from these first two categories I've talked about, the stress level for this kind of service offering is the highest of any of the ones we're gonna see here. If you are someone that does not do well under pressure, does not have a deep level of knowledge, is not able to roll with the punches or think on your feet, this is gonna be a very hard service for you. This is definitely one that I would not consider as your first offer if you're just getting started in ClickUp service providing. Definitely start with any of the other ones I'm gonna talk about before you go into this one, because the price point of these services can really vary, but sometimes they can tempt people a bit. So I would say on average, let's say a 1 hour intensive where there's prep, there's a session, and then there's post afterwards. These tend to vary from $150 for a 1 hour session all the way up to $1,000 for that same 1 hour session. But I don't want your eyes to go all googly eyes on me here when you hear those numbers, because even though strategy audits are generally intensive and you have, say, 1 hour with your client, that is not the only hour of work that you have to do. For example, here, I run 1 hour sessions. It can easily take me 3 to 3.5 hours to deliver a strategy session that's a 1 hour session. So if we were to assume that other people also take about 3.5 hours for a 1 hour intensive, the service range I really told you is more like $50 an hour to, you know, $300 and some an hour. And keep in mind, this is for a pretty high stress delivery vehicle. This is a pretty intense for everybody delivery vehicle. Now, the next way to monetize your ClickUp skills, which is, I was debating putting it in here or not, is ClickUp using services. So this is where you have a service you're offering, like virtual assistants, web design, whatever, but as part of your service, you are in someone's ClickUp account and you are using it at a, you know, expert level or proficient level. Rather than this truly being its own service, most often this is just used as an added feature or add a bonus to add on to an existing service. I cannot tell you how many times I've had people reach out to say, hey, do you have a VA who can do content repurposing and also knows ClickUp? The main reason people ask for these kinds of ClickUp users is because they want to skip the step of training someone to use ClickUp properly. When it comes to risk for the buyer, this actually is pretty low risk because they're just asking for someone with ClickUp skills on top of the additional service they're actually looking for. When it comes to the responsibility of the buyer, this is also pretty low. When it comes to the provider's stress level, this is a pretty average to low side of things. You're really not adding much onto your daily flow. You're just saying, hey, I'll do whatever I said I was gonna do, and I won't screw up your ClickUp while doing it. But because this is kind of a vague category of service, I will just say the pay on this completely varies. I would just say maybe add 10% onto your normal hourly rate for your type of skill. So if you're a web designer that normally charges $120 an hour, add 10% and be $132 an hour as a web designer who's also a ClickUp expert. And if someone really wants someone who's a ClickUp expert to be working on their stuff or working on their website, you will be worth that 10% or 20% price premium because of that extra skill. So rather than a pay on this one, just a price premium to add on to your normal rate. Now, we've talked about service providers, we've talked about productized services. Let's talk about products now. So the fifth way to monetize your ClickUp skills is to actually sell assets, to sell things, to create something of your knowledge and then charge for it. The most common way I see people get into this is to actually create a template. And then as part of their one-on-one engagements, they install that template. But as people evolve, they might want to sell that template to other people. And so that's when things like template shops and courses and eBooks and whatever, that all comes into fruition. While I've seen ClickUp templates out there ranging from $15 to some ridiculous ones at $200 for a list template, which is crazy to me that people pay for that. While that range is out there, I would say most templates end up around the $20 to $50 mark just because templates themselves don't carry too much value. But at that price point, it's really low risk for your buyer. However, it's still medium to high responsibility because those templates out of the box aren't really going to help. They're not really going to solve any problems until that buyer implements them and adjusts them to their own workflow. In terms of stress to the creator, you, it's pretty low stress to create these kinds of offers, but the actual management of these can bring it into that low to average territory because you do need to worry about things like sales tax, depending on where you're located. Managing questions from users and refund requests for those templates can eat up quite a bit of time, especially when you have a low ticket offer. You know, spending a lot of hours on that support can feel pretty draining. And I will also say ClickUp public templates are particularly buggy lately, and that is going to use a lot of your time, which again, when you're dealing with $27 offers, unless you have a larger audience, it's going to be very easy to not make very much from that. So you want to make sure if you're going into that route, you have reach or you have things so systemized that you won't have to do much in terms of support. Now, last but not least, the last way to monetize your ClickUp skills is to actually create content as a revenue stream. Now, many of you probably create social media content to market your business. That is not what I'm talking about here. To actually make this a revenue stream, I'm talking about creating content that you can make money from, preferably by not charging the viewer, like yourself. You are someone that's a great writer, you like speaking, you like video editing, start a YouTube channel, start a blog, start a paid newsletter, and create a revenue stream based around attention capture for your business. When it comes to the buyer of these services, it is very, very low risk because advertisers just go through AdSense and purchase these ad slots. And you, as our consumer, but not really buyer, you can just turn off this video at any point. When it comes to responsibility for you guys there, your responsibility is pretty high because I'm not here to help you if you have trouble implementing what we talk about in these videos. When it comes to the stress to the service provider, I would put this in the low category. There's not a lot of crazy uncertainty. There's not client calls or demands or emergencies. It's just sitting down, recording a video, editing it, and publishing it, or a similar process if you're doing a blog. But just like selling assets, and even more so than selling assets, this kind of world is a volume game. So if you thought $27 for a template felt like really cheap and that you're gonna need a lot of volume to make it make sense, content is even more extreme. So when we're talking like a few dollars per thousand views, and even less if you're talking about blogging, it's a numbers game. So when it comes to getting paid for this, I would definitely not treat this as your primary revenue stream unless you're working full-time and this is just a side hustle for you. But speaking from my own experience, it can add up over time. And like I said, I have a video talking through my numbers up here at the top if you want to see how much this channel makes being at the size it is now. Ooh, and just to jump in here with one bonus monetization option, training services is another one that I wish I would have included in this original recording, but while I'm sitting here editing this, I realize I really want to add it in. So training services is referring to using your time and your energy to educate others personally. So not so much in a content vehicle, but by having one-on-one sessions where you're educating people about basic features, basic functionalities. While strategy audits and similar skills require coaching or consulting skills, training requires more teaching skills and empathy. And because it is such a personal skill set, it's such a communication-based skill set, it can be a slightly more risky option for buyers versus just going with a setup service. Because when you're hiring somebody to train you, you're hoping that your teammates or your colleagues or your employees will like the trainer, will understand things from the training, and will retain the information from that training. However, as a service provider, training is actually a lower risk offer in that you're going to be teaching the same things over and over again. You don't really run the risk of being surprised by, you know, a foreign problem that you haven't yet solved. You're going to be repeating the same information to person, to person, to person. So if you're someone who prefers to teach than problem solve, training can be a really good option to look at. And when it comes to prices for training services, when you're doing it in this one-on-one format, we're looking at rates from $50 to $500 USD per hour, with the average probably falling around $175 or $200 per hour. Now, this is such a long video, but I did not talk about things like business model of, you know, freelance business owner versus agency. I didn't really talk about timelines of, you know, the difference between intensives and drawn out. I didn't talk about strategies or ways to add value, but I hope this was still a helpful video to give you some inspiration as to ways that you can monetize your ClickUp skills. If you have any questions about this, and I really hope you do have questions, please do leave them in the comments. Let's start a conversation about this. And I will also say, if you are a service provider, please go to the description and I would love to hear from you specifically. I am experimenting, I'm kind of working behind the scenes for some content specifically for service providers who are trying to provide these kinds of services. And I would really appreciate your feedback to let me know what you would value, what you would appreciate to know more about when it comes to providing these as services. So please go down the description and check that out. But otherwise, thank you guys so much for hanging with me on a long video here. See you in the comments, and until next time, enjoy the process.